When you're playing against 99 other teams, all right? So that should really excite you, and you should be really challenged by that and work really, really hard. But I think the whole idea about this game, besides, of course, learning through blended learning, you know, blended learning methods, is that it's aimed to stimulate interest and investment awareness in the FGIC market, and to educate beginners by providing first-hand trading experience, allowing students to develop an analytical mind and learn beyond the traditional classroom setting. But none of this would have been possible without the support of the founder and the managing director of End2End Connect, Mr. Andrew Hyun. And Mrs. Andrew Hyun, both of them, we're very, very grateful to you for supporting. None of it would have been possible without you. So thank you very much again on behalf of all the students and staff of Chile University. And now, the best for the last. The
we
teams.
Want to make the loudest noise, okay?
So we're going to have this.
Today, that company is valued at $350 billion. That man's name is Warren Buffett. And he is valued at $65 billion today. So it's pretty clear. Billions of dollars of profit. My job today is to help you acquire that skill. Today, we're going to be tackling three key questions that can help you increase your knowledge towards stock market, and hopefully your profits start here. So let us begin. The first question you like to ask yourself when entering the stock market is, what is a stock? A stock is simply put, a portion of a company's ownership. And I know what you're thinking at this point. Why in the world would the founding fathers of a company sell off or give away portions of their ownership? Well, that is because at any company's lifetime, the company needs to raise cash. And it could do that through two ways. It could either borrow money or it could sell off parts of its ownership. That process is called issuing stock. Now, where do you go to trade stocks? A company can't be going to every person asking you, hey, would you like to buy some stocks? It's ridiculous. That is why we have the stock market. The stock market is a regulated marketplace where companies and investors like yourselves could trade stocks. In Malaysia, we call our stock market Bursa. And on Bursa is listed every public listed company. Okay? So the second key question you have to ask yourself is, how do you earn money through investing stocks? Now, there are two main ways you can earn money through investing stocks. The first method is through dividends and capital gains. Dividends is one method, capital gains is the second method. Dividends is basically a sum of money that companies pay you for holding a portion of their share for a certain amount of time. Now, when you pay through dividends, you encounter two problems. The first problem is dividends is not obligatory. This means that not every company gives out dividends. Some may do and some may not. So the stock that you buy may not receive dividends. You got to check on that. The second problem you are going to encounter is that dividends are usually paid annually or semi-annually, meaning that you will only receive your dividends every 6 to 12 months. And because this game that we're going to host only lasts for 4 weeks, paying through dividends is unlikely to help you. The next method you can use to earn money through investing stocks is through capital gains. Now, when you play through capital gains, you follow a very important rule. That is buy low, sell high. That is the golden rule. For example, if I buy a pen for 50 cents and I sell my pen to this guy for 70 cents, 70 minus 50, I earn a 20 cent profit. That is how you earn through capital gains. The problem with capital gains is that,
it's very, very common.
And that law is that when demand for a good increases and supply remains the same, the market value for that good increases. The same thing goes with capital gains. When a company is doing very well and more people will want to demand that specific stock, that market price increases. And that is how you earn money through investing in stocks. Now, a problem arises in capital gains in this, but this is more related to real life situations. When you invest in a stock and you realize that you need money urgently, or for whatever reason you need to sell the stock, you need to sell the stock at the current market price. That means that current market price might be below the price you bought it at. In that case, you will be making a loss. The last question you have to ask yourself is, what affects price? I know I said that as long as you follow the law of demand of buy low, sell high, you will be theoretically making a profit. And yes, that is true. But the biggest problem here is that no one really knows when the price is going to go up or go down. And if you were to ask me what are the factors to affect price, I honestly can't tell you. Not many people can. This is because price is affected by so many factors. To name a few, these factors are economic health, inflation, or the company's health. There are so many factors affecting price that you can never correctly predict the next price direction. One noteworthy factor is discipline, the human discipline. Take this for example. When you buy a stock and you realize that your value is going up, because you would like to maximize profit, you will keep holding on to that stock. You wouldn't want to sell it. That is one of the things that affects price. Thankfully, because it's our first time having this game with N2N Connect Berhad, they have gladly opened up two resources inside the game. Those resources are fundamentals and charting systems. Now, using these two resources are very important. They are very powerful. Keep in mind, they will not predict accurately. It's because it's impossible. These tools will not predict accurately the next price direction, but what it does is gives you a very good idea of what may happen next. Ladies and gentlemen,
Many investors and professionals out there will always try to come up with theories. Theories to try to explain the price direction. However, it is important to realize that there is no one theory that can explain anything or everything. That is why it is so important that as players of this game, for you guys to research and study your company and then seek expert opinions before making a decision.
What you are doing.
That is why it is so important that you have a very good reason before making any decision. With that, I end my presentation. Thank you.
August 24, 2000, he obtained his diploma in computer studies from City Guild of London Institute, United Kingdom, in 1983. He started his career as a programmer with SGB GoTime Private Limited, a Singapore accounting software house, and was promoted to senior consultant at the age of 25. In 1989, he was awarded with the Best IT Auditor for Asia Pacific region, and since then, he has worked with a variety of renowned companies in Southeast Asia. Having gained wide exposure in both information technology and business operations, he began his entrepreneur pursuit in the year 2000 with several friends to start N2N. Ladies and gentlemen, to speak about the methods on investment and also provide some advice for stock trading, please welcome Mr. Andrew Tiang.
Idea of what investing in stock is all about. We're happy to be in partnership with Taylors to provide you with the stock game platform. This by no means it is an ordinary game because this is the first time you see a live trading system from the real world that people use real money to invest is being used for your game. So your game will be as real as anybody else. The only difference is the money you make is in is a virtual form of money, apart from the price that you're winning. And that you have to assess the risk factor, the decision you make, as if it's real life, because when you graduate or when you decide to venture into real investment, it will be the same kind of real-world tools that we will use to decide your decision. And there's a few steps that we will go through and I will share with you as we go along. Now, I'll give you a diagram of what the stock market is all about all over the world. You have obviously, the US market, the European market, and then the rest of it is major market. More and more attention are now being shifted to focus in Asia because Asia has the world's largest population. Okay? And Asia is very fragmented, with very diverse culture, very very different in the way things are being done. And it is the highest growth market with China, with Japan, with Korea, with the rest of the ASEAN countries put together. This is where the new focus of the real world is for people doing investment trading in the system. And the money that change hand runs into billions and billions of dollars. Stock market affects everyone's life, and this is therefore important for you to know. So in your work, your job, your parents' job, it will be affected by the economy, and the economy is interrelated to the stock market. Which is why it's important for you to get involved and get to be aware of what's going on with the rest of the world. Now, there are various types of investment. You have investment in equity, now commonly known as stock. You have investment in future. You have investment in option trading, commodity, which is the gold, the soya bean, the crude oil, etc. Then you have a fixed income, which typically refer to the bond, a company issue bond. Bond pay you, interest on the annual basis. And money market is referring to the forex, where
currencies are also being traded very actively. In fact, it's probably the most actively traded, you know, instrument in the world. Then, of course, you can also invest in insurance. Yes, insurance is a form of investment. Property is a form of investment. If you have no idea what to trade, then you use fund manager, you use exchange traded fund. So ETF refer to exchange traded funds, where they put together a basket of stock so that you are not, you know, exposed to one single risk, but you have a balance of risk in the basket of stock. So these are various types of investment that people can do. Now, why do people invest in stock market? Investing in stock market because of retirement planning. Okay? For many of the youngsters, they will invest in stock market because it is a growth of wealth. If you are only, you know, working after your graduation, you make maybe 3,000, you know, ringgit a month. You work for a few years, maybe you get increased to 5,000, 6,000 ringgit a month. That income is limited. There is little upside except the annual increment bonuses that you receive. You can never catch up with the real world, you know, in terms of the material cost, in terms of the cost of living standard that is going up. And this is why, you know, people have to resort to other form of income supplement. And investment is the kind of income supplement. And if you do it well and you're very good at it, then your income supplement might even surpass your primary income. Okay? And that is what Brian said. Warren Buffett, you know, has accumulated wealth to about $65 billion. He is currently ranked the third richest man in the world. And his job is just investing in the market. Okay? The stock that he picked to invest, you know, he will have a lot of followers that will come to him, you know, and invest along with him. And, you know, his investment share, I think there will be a topic to talk about it later. Is very valuable because of his experience. Okay? So, you know, you've got to understand that all the money that you make, your parent make, that is put in the bank, it is not enough to hedge against inflation. If someone put the money in the bank and the bank is paying you 2% interest, and inflation, you know, for the country is around 3%. Meaning to say that the money you put in the bank, despite earning interest, is being eroded.
So you have to therefore either work harder, maybe get 2 jobs. You know, some minister suggests that you get 3 jobs. Or you can learn how to invest, you know, and generate income. You know, and hopefully the returns of which, you know, is exceeding the inflation rate, so that you have a positive growth of wealth. Okay? So hedging against inflation through investment is an important element. Why some other people invest in stock market? Well, we don't really call them investment because they just feel excited about being part of the stock market. And that is more in the form of speculation and gambling. And certainly it is not something that we want to encourage. The very fact that N2N set up as a company, you know, and built a very advanced trading platform is actually to reduce the number of people, you know, speculating in the market. By giving them proper tools, by giving them proper knowledge and proper content, they are able to become a more informed investor. And therefore, they will not be burning their money away unnecessarily through, you know, the form of a speculation.
People must do in order for them to trade.
So the prerequisite is you obviously must have money. You need capital to start your investment. You know, if you don't have money, get some savings. If not, get your parents to get you some advance and make a deal to repay with interest. That is one form. You must obviously have a proper knowledge of investment. And this is why we think it's important that in this particular stock game, we open up a number of tools to allow you to have access to those information and tools to make the kind of decision. Otherwise, if you are just looking at the stock prices, you know, and then decide where to buy and where to sell, that's purely just speculation.
Information. You can then analyze, you know, and one of the important things is you should use those tools to analyze. These tools that we open up for your stock game,
is the first time ever that the stock game is played with those advanced tools. Okay, these tools for the real world, in your parents, if they are investing, you know, they are, the broker that provide this has to pay hundreds of thousands of dollars to provide those kind of content. And many of the investors have to even pay subscription fee to make use of those tools. Okay, and in this stock game, we think it is important that if you want to understand about proper investment, then you need to start with the proper way. And the proper way is to have a proper content, proper tools that help you analyze, you know, and get some idea where the direction is going to be and which stock you should be picking, why you pick the stock, you know, where is the trend, you know, direction is, and make that kind of investment decision. Okay. Which is why the school has organized it in a team of four, so that they have a group of people that you can discuss, you know, why you make that decision, and the one who win the argument will probably get to execute all that. People lose money in the stock market because they just have no discipline. Okay? You don't go and compete against the wave. If the wave is against you, you know, you gotta flow with the wave. You don't flow against the wave. And that is where discipline is important. Okay? If you have enough information, if you have enough tools, if the world goes into panic and everyone is selling and you have enough information, you know, you have discipline and patience, you might not fall into the mass psychology. And a lot of people are just following mass psychology. Everyone buy, they buy. Everyone sell, they sell. But if you are among the first few that decide, you probably will make money. If you are the follower, you probably will lose money because you end up buying higher, okay, and you're not able to sell higher. Now, what are the kind of mistakes that people commonly make? I say it's important you don't confuse speculation gambling with trading and investment. There is a totally different kind of element. When you talk about speculation, it's to make a decision with no idea what it's all about. That's purely speculation. You just have a hunch, you know, that this is going to go this way, that's going to go that way. Okay? Sometimes you're lucky. Sometimes you're not lucky. You know, you might be lucky 7 out of 10 times. The 3 times you're not lucky might wipe out all the gain that you have. Okay? So you cannot just rely on luck in investment, because that would be just pure gambling. What is the difference between trading and investing? There is a difference. Okay? Trading is where you buy and sell. Buy and sell. That's trading, right? Something change hand. Investing is where you buy and hold. People who do investing are people with a longer term view. If you have money that you want to set aside and your horizon is, you know, 2 years, 3 years, 5 years, that is investing. If you say that, well, I have money, you know, I'm not going to do anything until Christmas time, so I have 3 months, you know, I want to you know, take this money now and try to make some gain out of it. Well, that is trading. Because you will have a trading loss. If you are lucky, you know, and it happens to go up, then you will make trading gain. But if you have proper tools, proper content, you do a proper analysis, it is possible still that in the 30 days to 90 days, you can still make money. Which is why analysis is very important. Okay? Don't just purely speculate. A lot of people, there's a new term in the market. We call it speculvestor. Why is it called speculvestor? They started speculating. They get caught. They become long-term investor. Because you can't sell at a loss, right? And you want to hold on to your losses. You become a long-term investor. So from speculator to become investor, we call it speculvestor. Now, the other thing that you want to do is you have to have enough research of your investment. You're dealing with dollar and cent, yeah? Although in the game, you're not dealing with real cash. In the real world, you deal with real cash. And when you deal with real cash, you have to be very careful with the decision you make. You must have enough research. You must understand what you're doing. You must understand the company you're going to invest. What is the company doing? If you just go in blindly because somebody says it's good. When somebody says it's good, you've got to double check. Okay? Now, a lot of time, again, people invest without horizon in mind. So I said, you know, if you are going to do an investment, don't just look at short term unless you are prepared to lose everything. Okay? You can go short term. Okay? You can gain, for sure. But if you are prepared to lose, then you can do short term. Otherwise, you have to go long term. You know, history has proven that over a longer horizon, the stock market always rises. Over the longer horizon. But if you buy into a company that is not well managed, the industry that is a sunset industry, then, you know, very quickly, you know, your investment will vaporize. Which is why researching is important. Don't go into a sunset industry, you know, go into the emerging industry. You know, emerging industry out of 1,000, you know, high-tech company, you know, 995 will fail. Okay, the five is successful. If you can pick the five, you make your money. If you pick the 995, you lose your money. And this is why research is important. We provide you the tools, you know, it has all the real-time announcements. It has all the shareholders, content in there. It has all the company synopsis. It has all the financial, you know, for the company for the last 5 years. You have enough information to analyze, and therefore you will know whether the stock you pick is the likely one that is going to sustain or the one that is going downhill. Okay? Come with the risk. There is no investment that has no risk. In fact, the higher return that you want tend to come with higher risk. We call high risk, high return. Low risk, low return. No risk, no return. Okay? What is your own risk tolerance? Okay? And if you violate the risk tolerance, you have to decide to cut loss. We call it cut loss. If you make a wrong decision, for goodness sake, don't hold on to, you know, the stock that is going nowhere. You know, where there is residual value, cut loss and move your funds to elsewhere. If you keep holding to a stock that is dying, you know, it's only a matter of time, right? So that's important. You know, this stock is going to fly. You know, don't sell house, you know, sell property, sell car, and put your money in there. Never do that. Because, you know, if you are wrong, you're completely wiped out. So we always say that you must do your own education. You know, you've got to pick a few stocks. You know, some has high return, you know, with higher risk. Some has lower return, but very stable. You know, some has, you know, average return. You know, it will give you mitigated risk. So if you put your portfolio and you have a proper portfolio, then your risk, you know, is mitigated. You have growth, you know, but your downside is also protected. That's why we say you should invest in a basket of stock, not just invest in one or two single stock. Because that is no different from just speculating and gambling. Okay? Now, thinking of low-cost investment is always good? No. Some people think that, okay, you know, I can buy the penny stock, I can buy more. Yes, in percentage gain-wise, it will give a better return. In percentage gain-wise. Okay? In absolute gain-wise, depends. If you are having to buy a penny stock, you know, if it's a penny stock because the company is not doing well. Investing in a company is not doing well will not generate good return, and therefore the price is not going to fall, you know, as much. So those are the kind of considerations one might have. Okay? Now to think that market is perfect and efficient, it is not always right. Market may be perfect, in some market may be perfect. Some market are very notorious, okay? It is the people that are not perfect. It's the people not efficient. It's the collective action of the whole group that determine the market direction, right? It's the whole market psychology. If everyone is going to jump in the buy, the stock will go up. If everyone is going to leave the market, the stock will go down. So it's the mass market psychology. So that is important, you know, to understand that you are playing against other people's psychology. That's important. Now, for those who invest in rumor space, okay, rumor space, because you're a rumors investor, this is where somebody hear from somebody that something is good, something is going to go up, buy the stock. Okay.
when the whole market is filled with rumors, it's probably time to get out. Okay, because the market is not having fundamental anymore. So when it's totally rumors real market, it's not a market you want to get in. When you start to hear from your neighbor, your neighbor's auntie, you know, giving you tips, it's probably a high risk warning signal. Okay? Now, other people, you know, always get insider tips. Just for your information, insider trading is considered illegal. If you get hold of news or information from the insider and you act on insider trading, if you are caught, you can be prosecuted. Okay? If you are not caught, of course, you know, you make a good deal. Okay? But you must always be mindful. Okay? Insider trading, for people who have privileged position, hold that information, if he start to act on trading, it's considered illegal. Okay? Now, there are people who do what we call momentum trading. Momentum trading are people that actually trade because there is high volume. You know, easy to get in, easy to get out. And the momentum trading, they always go for very low return. Maybe 2%, 3%, 5%, but because they buy in volume, they buy in millions. So when you buy a million, the 2% return of million in one day itself, how much is that? 1%? 1 million? 10,000. Is 10,000 a good return?
Yes.
A day, right? So for those people who do momentum trading, that's what they do. They move high volume, okay, and they get very small percentage of return. They get in, get out, get in, get out. No. If you want to do momentum trading, you must be very good. You must be very fast. Because you have to get in when the momentum is riding, you get up before the momentum ends. Okay? So there are people who do momentum trading. Some people call it high frequency trading. You heard of this terminology? Yes? Okay, robot. So they invented robotic program that does this kind of trading. So a robotic program, they can issue, you know, hundreds of thousands of trading instructions in 1 second. Okay? The fastest person who can trade human is 3 orders in 1 second. Now, of course, what we are trying to promote here is value-based investment, which is why we give you fundamental, we give you a lot of tools so that you can analyze. Over a longer period of time, fundamental investment always have a better return, safer return, you know, and your downside is more protected. There is an emerging trend of people, what we call them the chartists. These are what we call the trend-based trader. Trend-based trader is slightly different from fundamental trader. They are also very different from momentum trader. Okay? Trend-based trader are people that ride with the wave. If the market is going up, the particular stock is going up, they ride with the wave. You know, and then before the wave end, you know, they will get up so that, you know, they are along with the wave. So there are different techniques. There are something I can show you how people do, you know, trend-based trading. And you can make in combination. Okay? Your value-based trading and trend-based trading can be put together so you have a hybrid strategy. So, you know, I want you to understand how the market really works. Okay? In order for the, you know, whoever that started this rumors trading to make money, they have to make money from somebody else. So when they started with the rumors trading, you can typically see a trend. Okay? There must be a market maker collaborating with a major shareholder because you need a block of share. Without a block of share, you cannot drive the market direction.
Wait. Because slow, slow.
DCSA!
One more time.
DCSA!
One more time!
Yeah.
Go.